Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer from TiffanyHarpandSong.com, and welcome to Tune Tutor, where we learn traditional tunes the traditional way by ear. And today we're going to be learning what I always knew as 58 or number 58, and it is the 58th entry in Patrick McDonald's collection and is unnamed in that collection. You can see it right here. It's in two lines right underneath My Love is Fixed on Donald. Here are the two lines of number 58. I was asked to introduce what this collection is, give a bit of background on it, and you can see the full, very, very long title is A Collection of Highland Vocal Airs, Never Hitherto Published, to which are added a few of the most lively country dances or reels of the North Highlands and Western Isles, and some specimens of bagpipe music by Patrick McDonald. So this collection was first published in 1784, and scotlandsmusic.com says of the book, he gives reference to tunes in the collection which he remembers as being the ancient harp music played in the Highlands. The clarsic had already fallen out of use by this time, but it was still within living memory, so the references are invaluable today to harp players seeking original tunes. End quote. Also, Patrick's brother Joseph published the first book of written pipe music, which was called A Complete Theory of the Scots Highland Bagpipe. So that would be another good resource for original tunes. I'll put a link to Patrick McDonald's collection in my description if you would like to purchase it. The tunes in this book all just have melody lines, so they're just waiting to be arranged by harpers or some other instrumentalist. I've arranged this for easy, late beginner, and for also intermediate harpers. And you can hear what my arrangement sounds like by clicking up here or in the description, and you can watch me play it. If you'd like to have sheet music for my arrangement of this, you get both the easy and the intermediate, and that is linked below in the description as well. I also have complete video lessons on how to play my arrangements. So let's put our harps into the key of G. You want your F levers up, and let's learn tune number 58 by ear. All right, so in the key of G, we have our F's sharp. Everything else is natural. And by the way, let me know in the comments if you know of any other names this tune goes by. I've also heard it called Ho Should He Come, but I have no idea who the he is, and I can't find anything on the internet about it. So let me know if you know this as a different name. We're gonna start with a very simple shape. And one thing to really challenge yourself when you're learning a tune by ear is to not look at all, but see if you can pick out this phrase on your own just by listening to it and see if you can find the strings on your harp without looking. So if I were to play without telling you what I'm playing, could you find it on your harp? You know we're in the key of G. Very likely we're going to have a G in our first phrase, and that's what we do. We're going to play this little shape here, which Carol Coppice calls a crab, and I like that because it looks like a little crab claw. You have two fingers next to each other on the D and the E, and you're skipping the F. And we're just gonna play the G first. We've skipped the F, our thumb is on G. You're next gonna play the two bottom notes from the bottom to the top, so D, E. And then while you are playing those, you've got your thumb back on the G. We're gonna do this a couple of times, so it's good just to get this pattern in your head and just play it over and over. So as fingers three and especially two are playing, before two finishes, you want your thumb to be back on that G so it's ready to go. Tell you how many times we're just going to play that little crab shape phrase. We're going to start with the G, play your D, E, play your G again, play your D, E. This time you're not going to go back to G. You're going to start bringing your thumb all the way up to the D, the high D. So this G here, we're only going to play it twice in this phrase. Just listen to the whole phrase. And if you can pick it out without even looking, good for you. Great. So you're not going to be able, probably, to reach your thumb all the way to this G as you're playing this E. That's quite a big stretch. So what you can do instead is just have the idea of your thumb kind of going, starting to go back, just start to get it ready. As you're playing that E. So what you don't want to do is keep your thumb down and low and then have to jump up here. So you just want to start to get it primed and ready to move to that D. All right, and this isn't an easy 6/8. So we have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is our next phrase. As you come to this D with your thumb, you do want to place your second finger on A before you play that D. And here is your little three in a row, the three clear strings in a row, but we're going to start with the middle one. See if you can sort out this phrase without looking. One more time. Just those three strings in the middle that are clear, not red or blue. So let's try this whole phrase together and then we'll play it slowly. Great, I'll do that again and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How did you do? Let's look at the very next phrase. It's going to be very similar to the first. So you already know that. Let's sandwich all those together. We're going to start with the crab, come up to the D, play this middle bit, and then you're going to start right back into the same crab shape. And then just stop there at the E. So let's play all that together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To hop onto that G and that crab shape again pretty quickly after you play this G. So you're gonna have two G's in a row. And let's just go through that one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's right away. You just get that new shape onto your harp, and you do want to try and place all three of those fingers at once. So let's try the next phrase after we have finished this one the second time. We're not going up to the D this time, we're going up to the A, so it's a much shorter distance. In fact, you can get that thumb on A before you even play this E, and that would be a good way to connect it. Now we have a new shape. As we play that A, we're also going to get our second finger onto the G and our third finger onto E. So this is like the beginning shape, but it's opposite. So now we don't have a space in the thumb. We have the gap string between the second and third finger. And you can think of that as an okay. We're going to play it down, A, G, E. So let's play that new phrase from the second crab. That one, all right? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You don't want to play that thumb until 2 is on G. Likewise, you don't want to play G until 3 is on E. Just connect everything. It's like being on the monkey bars. You always have one hand on the monkey bars or you're going to fall. It's the same kind of idea. At the end of a phrase like this, we have lots of time to relax and replace. After that, we're going to play the very same phrase we played in the beginning. All the way up to D. Alright. So that was phrase 3, which is the same as 1. Now we're going to learn a new phrase and then put them all together. We're going to start on A with our same OK shape we had before. Get used to that. This time we're going to bring our thumb all the way up to D again. So just get used to doing that phrase. Again, we're skipping the F. We have a gap between fingers 2 and 3. Alright, after that D, second finger is going to go to A again. Here's what you have to practice. If you're not used to crossing over and under, we are going to play our D with the second finger on A, and as we play it, just kind of propel your thumb over onto the G. Right below this A, your second finger is on. Then you're going to play your second finger. So you can just practice that motion if that is something newer to you. Don't play 2 until the thumb is on G. Now that your second finger has played, you're ready to return to that same crab shape we had in the beginning. We're going to play it down. Here's the new phrase again. We're starting with the OK from A, G, E. 2 on A, cross. And here's the count for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just listen to that rhythm. Let's play the whole A part. You just learned the entire first half of the song. We can think about it, remember, in 4 sections. The first section is this. Up to D. A, B, A, G. Here's the second section. Up to A. And the OK shape. We're going to start the third, which is the same as the first. Here's the new one. OK shape. Cross. Now here's a tip. When you're going from the third section here, you actually want to bring your thumb to that A before you play the G with your third finger, so that you're ready to do this OK shape, because it comes very quickly. So let's just do that little phrase again. I'm going to do the third phrase, which sounds just like the first, and go into the last phrase. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we go. Thumb on A. So pause that. Go back where you need to. Go over that part several times until you can do it in your sleep. And then let's learn the B part, the B section. You're going to play, most likely, the A part that we just learned twice, and then you're going to play the B part we're going to learn twice. So here is simplified version. I've taken out the ornaments here, and then we'll talk about ornaments after this, and see if you can find, again, what notes I'm playing, or at least some of them, without looking. let's just go that far first. We'll start with the first little phrase. And again, this is set up just like the A part, because you have a section one, you have section two, you have section three, which is exactly like one, and then you have section four. So let's start with two fingers right next to each other, one and two, on E with the thumb, D with the second, but we're gonna play two first. We're gonna do two Ds. And before you play that thumb, make sure your second finger goes to B, because that's what's next. Great, now you're gonna do a third. Just B to D. Let's put that together. Two Ds. And you probably guessed it, we're going to actually put our second finger somewhere else before the thumb plays. It's again that monkey bar idea. You always want to keep a hand on there so you don't fall. Put your second finger to A. So let's do that again, from two Ds to the E. Here's a third. Here's a fourth. So here's how you can remember this, how it will look on your harp. You're going to start with an interval of a second, two strings right next to each other. You can place a fourth down, and then you're just going to play a third. So our interval is getting bigger now. Now we're going to place a fourth down and play a fourth. So our intervals keep getting bigger. You start with a second, a third, and then a fourth. So here's two Ds again. One third here, B to D. Then you have D to A. And here we have our little phrase we've done before. So just A, dance around those three strings in the middle. Let's put all that together. One, two, three, four, five, six. And then you're just going to start it over. This time we're going to cross again. Before you play B, put your thumb on A. So let's just do that much. Thumb on A. One more time. Two Ds. Thumb on A. Okay, now we'll move on. We're going to do this same OK shape, where we have the gap between the second and third finger, skip the F. Same one we've had before. Let's put all that together, two Ds. One, two, three, four, five, six. Two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, go ahead and rewind that. Go through that a few times just to get it in your head. Next, we're going to do the exact same phrase as the first. Two, three, four, five, six. One, two, four, five, six. We only have one more phrase to learn, and you'll be happy to know it's exactly as the end phrase from the A section. That. Let's play our third phrase, which is like the first, two Ds. We climb down a third and a fourth. Again, thumb on A before we play that G, just like we did before. Now you're ready to do this next phrase, the little OK shape. Again, before you play that high D, second finger on A, you know this part. Before we play the A, skip that thumb down to G right below it. Here's our crab shape that we started with. Great. So let's play this whole tune together. After you've gotten the B part a little more comfortable in your hands, let's start at the very beginning. And then I'm going to show you some ornaments that you can use that are in the original notation. All right. We're going to start with our crab shape. Remember, you do the top, then the bottom, then the middle. That's how it goes for this beginning. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Up to D. Talk about ornamentation real quick. I'll link my ornament video up in the cards up there if you haven't seen it yet. Explain some of these in more depth. In the original Patrick McDonald collection, there are a couple of extra things you can do. For the melody, so it's just a little cut up from the E to the A. You can do that with 3-1 or 2-1. Might be a little easier to do it with 3 because you just used 2. It's just an extra E before you get to the A. And then for the next phrase, they have a little cut here. So you could use I would replace, after I play my 2 on that A, replace and do 1 and 2 on A G. So you can have an extra A and then play 3-4 on my E D. The B part, we have another little cut here on this little ornament here. I like to do these with 2 and 1, even though I'd be hopping with my thumb, probably not the best form. You could also do it with 3-2, 2-3-2, and then bring your thumb up to the E, Sometimes I'll even put a triplet in there and just play three because I like it. Same thing, it just cuts on that little, that double D note there. That's where they have them. And of course, you can put them wherever you like and wherever sounds good to you. There you go. Thank you for learning this tune with me. If you liked it, please leave it a thumbs up or a comment so I know. Those things really help this video get noticed by YouTube so even more people can learn this charming tune. If you learn this tune and feel like sharing, I would so love to hear your version of it. You can tag me on Instagram at Tiffany Harp and Song, or you can contact me through my website, which is all linked in the description. Don't forget to subscribe right here for more free videos. Why not try this tune next if you liked number 58? And you can also click over here to visit Patreon and check out the extra rewards like the video lessons on the arrangement that I talked about and sheet music as a package deal. I'll see you next time.